Okay, I'm going to show you some scary statistics as it relates to human overpopulation. As you can see, we're over 7 billion humans in the world and exponentially growing at a rapid rate, more rapid than ever in history. You can see the number of births are outnumbering deaths. In addition to human overpopulation, our oceans are overfished with mile-long nets that rape the oceans. We have nasty fish farms now, like cruel factory farms of billions of animals, which I'm going to click on now. Meatvideo.com for factory farms, where they torture billions of animals. Meat also is horrible for the environment. Increases world hunger. Every 10 to 12 pounds of corn or grains fed to force-bred animals only gives about 1 pound of cooked flesh in return. So every 10 to 12 pounds of feed you give them, you only get 1 pound of meat in return. So while humans go hungry, force-bred animals are well-fed inefficiently. Another case for veganism is it's one of the best things for the environment. Meat is a leading cause of greenhouse gases. And it's also horrible for our healthcare system. So as you can see, the most killed animals are chickens. Most eat about 35 birds a year. 35 for nearly 8 billion humans is quite a bit. And they're actually treated horribly. Egg production is also very cruel, as well as pig and pork. And factory farms are probably the cruelest. So again, meatvideo.com for factory farm videos. Go through some other statistics here. Again, back to population. Go by demographic. Now by region, some cultures and religions don't believe in birth control, something we're going to have to reevaluate and evolve. Here's deaths by injury, type of injuries, some interesting statistics. Diseases. Heart disease is a leading killer still. And it's mainly from animal cholesterols. Another case for veganism. I believe we should take care of the humans we have first before bringing more into the planet. So I believe that they should stop giving the free $3,900 per kid per year in tax refunds that we all pay for breeding, especially when there's tons of kids in foster care, especially teenagers. The pro-lifers would adopt these kids that they claim to care about. That would help a lot too. Here's some environmental facts. Again, resources are scarce. We only have limited resources. Our landfills are filling up. We're not the only species. There's millions of species. Even though we act like we're the only species, we're extincting many, cutting down more woodlands, rainforests, and such. Landfills filling up, polluting more waters. Not just BP, but again, overfishing, nasty fish farms, like the cruel factory farm. We can't exponentially grow and endlessly grow. Some other facts. Back down to food production. Crime. So please, no more than one kid max before we end up like China with quotas and actually have to find them, which we're going to eventually be reactive to rather than proactive. So stop being selfish, You don't need to a bunch of mini-me's or to spread your seed to feed your ego. You don't need any kids. Spread your influence on the world in a positive way. Go vegan as well. Meatvideo.com on factory farms. So again, consider this information. Great website. Podwaddle.com. PODWADDLE.com. Go to Earth Clock Statistics and you can see some scary statistics that we need to act on now. It's possibly already too late. Again, check out Factory Farms as well, meatvideo.com and podwaddle.com for important information to have a positive influence on the world.